Welcome back. Today we're talking about why high school boys are making a decision to be sexually active. And the first two reasons are the same as high school girls. First one is social status. They want to fit in, they want to be popular. I think this is even more of an issue for boys than it is for girls, because I think boys are much more embarrassed to admit that they're virgins than girls are. The second reason is relationship pressure. And what's different about this one is we have always believed that boys were the ones who were pressuring girls into having sex. What I have found in the 11 years that I've been doing this is things have really changed. And now girls are much more aggressive. In many cases, girls are initiating the sex. So guys have a lot of pressure on them to be sexually active based on what their girlfriends want to do. The third reason is something that I don't often hear from girls. And that is just that they want the pleasure, or they just had sex just for fun. And I guess that's not really surprising when you think about the fact that girls are more emotionally driven to be sexually active, and guys are more physically driven to be sexually active. Let me read you a couple of quotes that I got from high school boys. The first guy says, "I didn't care whether or not I had sex, with who, or how many. I just saw it as pleasure and having a good time." That's not something that I would hear from a girl in a letter. The second one is, "I was one of those people who did not care. I had sex just for fun. I did not even really need to know the person. I just wanted to satisfy my own needs." The final two reasons that I get from high school boys of why they're having sex are somewhat similar. The first of the two is that they're saying that no adult has ever told them not to have sex. I will never forget a young man in one of my high school classes who was so amazed about a message of abstinence, because he said no adult in his life has ever told him not to have sex. He said every adult in his life has always just told him to use a condom, because they just assumed that he was going to do it anyway. And the second of the two is even more disturbing, because that reason is because they are being encouraged to have sex by the adult men in their lives, whether it's their fathers, sometimes their uncles, sometimes they've said, you know, coaches on their athletic teams. Let me read you a couple of letters that I've gotten from high school guys. The first letter from a high school guy says, "My dad never showed me the right things to do. He told me to have sex because that makes me a man. I've now had 9 sexual partners." Wow. High school student with 9 sexual partners because his father encouraged him to have sex. The second letter is from another high school guy, says, "To be honest, I never really considered abstinence. My whole life, my uncles and dad always teased about having sex, and all of my cousins encouraged me to have sex." We can't really be surprised about the amount of teenagers who are sexually active when we have this kind of behavior happening with our teenagers, with the pressure that they're getting from adult men that they look up to and they respect when they're telling them to become sexually active. So based on what you've heard, what can you do to make it less likely that your son or any young man in your life that you're mentoring makes a decision not to have sex? The first thing is, we've got to stop with the double standard. We have to have a consistent message for girls and guys, because so often we tell girls not to have sex and we tell guys just to use protection. The next thing is, we've got to start teaching boys refusal skills just as much as we do girls. Because for years we've told girls, if he tells you if you love me, you will, then you need to tell him that. Well, with girls being just as aggressive, if not more so, we've got to start giving those same messages to boys, unfortunately. The third thing we can do is to make sure that they hear the message from mothers and from fathers. They've got to hear from strong men that it's okay for them not to be sexually active. Not only is it okay for them to not be sexually active, but they shouldn't be sexually active. The next thing that we have to do is to help young men understand that the definition of manhood is based on discipline, self-control, and other character traits, and not whether they're sexually active or not. There's been such a skewed definition of what manhood is, coming from the media, coming from society, and unfortunately coming from a lot of adult men or their parents. The final reason is the same thing that I said for high school girls, is role modeling. And I can't stress that enough. We have to have enough strong men out there who are showing young men that they have to respect young ladies, they have to love them enough to do what's best for them. So make sure you tune in next week so that you can hear why high school boys are making a decision not to have sex. And trust me, you are going to be surprised by some of the reasons, and you will definitely be encouraged. One of my most favorite groups is talking to high school boys, because they're so honest, but they're also receptive to this message when it's presented in the right way. So thanks for stopping in, and until next time.